calendar may say autumn, but temperatures are still pretty sweltering here in North Florida. But the good news, the radar is clear. Still, hydration will be key today at TIAA Bank Field in Jacksonville. Today, we've got a good Week 5 matchup in store here between the Kansas City Chiefs and the Jacksonville Jaguars. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
Type plays. That was absolutely a thunderbolt. And on the defensive side, he spent all week scheming, all week preparing, and it seems like it goes right out the window.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Try and strike this drive in the air. Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete.
That certainly appeared to be a play call where they were just trying to make second down, second and short. I think they thought the coverage was off a little bit more than it was. Nice job there pressing up on it and forcing the incompletion.
He's going to keep this again. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. That's a big loss of three, and it brings up third down.
I tell you, he brings the wood when he comes flying up in run support. He may be a safety, but he hits like a linebacker.
Not an easy spot here. They'll be in search of 13 yards to try to pick up the first. And the Chiefs are going to get him. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game. On fourth down, on is Logan Cook to punt. They punted three times in the loss last week as he sends this one away. Now here's Ross. Just a net of 34 there following a punt of 44 yards. And it's Chiefs football, first and 10. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that.
Three tight ends in the ball game here on first and 10. And they'll keep leaning on the running game. Back to the ground. And room there to work it inside the 25. 103 yards rushing for him as he's got the afternoon off to a great start.
And it is still early, just the first quarter. But you start prorating the numbers, and we might be in for some history. I mean, that last run puts him over 100 yards already. And we've still got three quarters to go.
And he'll get it down this time to the 17. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. And I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
On the ready.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. And they work this near the five. 6. Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. Try to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal.
Ready.
A handoff out of the gun, and that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down. Now Lawrence caught. Kelsey left side, and just 2 yards in. On for the field goal try, Jonathan Garibay. From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. Garibay's kick is good. So another scoring drive there, Charles, and an early 2-score lead.
You'd like the 6 there, partner, but you'll take the 3, and I think they have to be happy about the way they moved the ball in these first 2 drives. They have to feel good about their opportunities the rest of the game.
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. They'll look to get something started. They need to, down 10-0 early as they've got it first and 10. And a short pickup to about the 27. It'll be second down. This defense for the Chiefs, they were excellent last week in the win over the Chargers.
And every defensive team that we talk to, they spend a lot of time talking about creating turnovers. And anytime you get 2 or more in a game, you've had a really good performance. Exceeded that.
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sack.
They just gave up a sack there, and if I'm not mistaken, they gave up 4 last week, didn't they?
Yes. And you know, just looking really porous, aren't they?
They really are, and I'm wondering if they're going to have to start thinking about keeping the tight end in, maybe a back, someone to help assist, because right now, their quarterback's been getting hit a lot in the last couple of games.
Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. Trying to fit it into Moore, but it's intercepted. Hooked off by Ashton Davis. And the Chiefs are going to take possession of the football. And they'll take possession already in the red zone and in a great spot to add points to the scoreboard.
And Brandon, how many times have we seen a defense with a lot of field behind them get even more aggressive, right? They feel like they've got them not pinned down, but in a favorable spot for them. And they took advantage of it there. Got a nice interception and set up their offense in great shape.
From the 13, now they work on 1st and 10. A quick throw knocked away. It's incomplete.
And to put it mildly, this is a tough spot defensively. They have to come right back out and defend their red zone. But how about that good first step towards forcing them to settle for at least 3 points? I think they're also thinking bigger right now. Imagine being able to stop them totally and change the momentum.
One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of 4. Now 3rd down.
That was well played there defensively. 2 tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them 7 blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through. But that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is 3rd and long. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. And the Jags are going to take over at their own 11-yard line.
And that felt like a little extra pressure on that 3rd down attempt, and their mistake cost them points because they're inside the red zone. So you know you've got at least a field goal waiting for you. And in this case, they end up with nothing.
And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line.
You can almost hear the sigh of relief coming from their sideline and from their point on the field, because this has been a tough start for them thus far. A much-needed first down there. They needed something good to happen. Plays like that will continue to help them dig out of this hole.
He gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
The Jaguars at 1-3 here in the early part of the year. Yeah, they've lost 3 straight here, and it kind of goes without saying, I guess, but they could certainly use a win.
Yeah, no doubt about that. There's a difference between a losing stretch and a losing streak.
It's intercepted. And the Chiefs are going to take possession of the football.
This is where long-term starters in the NFL separate themselves from the rest of the pack, because there's still 3 full quarters left in this one. More than enough time to move past a pair of early mistakes and find a way to lead your team to a win. Mental resiliency, a characteristic every NFL team's looking for in their quarterback.
And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11.
Well, that was one of the few times they've been able to contain him thus far. He's over 100 yards for the game, but he lost a bit off his total on that carry.
After the loss to start out, here's 2nd and 11.
Look at me. Go! Go!
Snap to Lawrence as he taps this forward. And he gets this to the 35. Good for a gain of 5.
A nice play design there with a touch pass. Looked good at the start, but bottom line, the defense was ready.
And they did a nice job scouting, didn't they? Not just scouting, but now executing once they saw the play for real. After having worked out here all week in practice, they drilled on the play.
Blitz coming, and down he goes.
Okay, I'm not sure you could actually draw a better pass rush than that one right there. Nowhere to go outside. He had to keep backing up and backing up and backing up. Eventually dropped for a huge loss.
On 4th down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive.
Well, still early in this one, Charles, but the last time this offense was out there, they threw their first interception of the ball game. So trying to avoid repeating that mistake here on this drive.
And to put a positive spin on it, at least it happened in the first half and not in a close game in the fourth quarter. But you're absolutely right, partner. One of the last things this offensive quarterback wants to witness again in this game.
Kind of an obvious question, Charles, but anything you try to avoid after your first pick, or you say it's one interception, we're still in the first half, I'm about to do the same thing?
I think you want to avoid playing scared, you know, and put it into the mind of the quarterback that you've lost confidence in him. Make sure you get some throws that he's going to be able to complete, make him feel good about himself, and continue to run your offense.
The throw on the quick slant going to be complete. It'll go down as a gain of 6, and now it's 3rd and 3. Looking to throw. And able to find Kirk complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
Yeah, these are the types of plays they're going to need to hit on if they're going to get back into this game. It hasn't been the greatest of first halves, but this is a nice throw here on 3rd down, and they keep the drive going.
Well, nice throw here.
Exactly right. Like a dunk in basketball, like a home run in baseball, maybe a solo shot. Sometimes you need that big play to get things ignited.
They'll look to throw. And he's got it. They convert for 2, and that gets him even closer. Now a 2-point game.
After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. But Charles, a very uninspired effort. The last time we saw them out there was a quick three and out, then they punted the football.
Yeah, and you never want to get stopped so soundly.
He's got a man complete. And in for the Chiefs touchdown. Mecole Hardman, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Chiefs are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point up and good by Garibay. And the lead is now 17-8. Garibay back out there now to send this one away. Now, and Charles, you'd have to think a fair amount of concern is developing over there on that sideline.
And there should be, because essentially he's been a little loose and possibly reckless with the football here in the first half. Now, maybe it's not all on him, but still three interceptions. That puts the entire team in jeopardy. So the play caller from here on out, got to design some throws for him that he can complete, keep it away from the defense, and try and get him back on track.
They have three tight ends in that formation. That's almost a universal sign that they're planning to run the football. But how about the defense there? They met force with force and caused a stack up behind the line of scrimmage and threw it for a loss.
Gets it to Hardman. Jet sweep. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of five or six.
I don't care what the emphasis is in the NFL at any given time. Every defense is still going to say their number one goal every game is stop the run. And right now, they're not doing that. And that really chips away at your confidence.
On third down, they're going to run for it here. And they're going to get him down well short of the field. Give him 2 yards on that play. And that'll bring up fourth down. Garibay's kick is good, and that stretches this lead to 20-8. So the interception set him up with terrific field position, but 3 points, the end result.
Yeah, we can make this one pretty simple, partner. You always want to end drives with points, but that's one that you're going to look back on and probably say, we should have done better there.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And for this offense, Charles, you got to think kind of crucial here to put something together on this drive, because remember last time out, they threw the interception on the very first play.
And you can't afford to let this defense keep building any more momentum. They're playing awfully well, and they're awfully confident right now. To me, it's time to attack and take some of that momentum back. But make sure you're selective in doing so. Understand where you want to throw the football and make sure it's open before the ball leaves your hands.
And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
Well, he was a busy man out of the backfield a week ago. They got him open. I have no doubt in my mind that he'll be a big part of the game plan here as well.
Now a play fake here on first down. And he will find the open man. It's DJ Moore. And they're going to get this to about the 44-yard line. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
So first and 10 now from the 30. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete.
He didn't just deny a big throw there. He broke that one up in the red zone. An excellent play. One that may help save points on the board when this drive is over.
Again, he'll drop to throw. That's going to be caught by Kirk. And they're going to move it down to inside the 25. This offense so far on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 4. Back to throw again. Ball hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Partner, what we're seeing so far is a defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
Okay, ready. Already down 2 scores. They're going to go for this rather than settle for 3. They'll look to throw again. It's complete. Swings it out to his running back. And he is going to have the Jaguars first down as they manage to convert. And that'll keep the drive alive. Straight ahead, Gibson. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down.
The passing game's been working quite well so far, but the running game's been a little bit of a struggle. That's a surprise to me. Typically, when you can throw it, you've opened up lanes for your runners.
Here's a 2nd and 7. That's complete to Travis Etienne out of the backfield. It'll be a loss of 2, maybe 3 on the play. And that brings up 3rd and a full 10 yards.
I really like the angles that the tacklers came from on that play. They secured inside, took away the cutback. The sideline's there, so you can only go so far outside. And they were able to close in and tackle him for a loss.
Yeah, they use your boy over there, the 12th man. Sammy sideline, right?
Sammy sideline. You know something? He tackles pretty well, too.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Jacksonville. A great effort there. 2 catches, 2 touchdowns here so far. And the Jaguars have cut it back within a score. CD for them, this has just been an offensive explosion here in the 2nd quarter.
Yeah, helped scoreless in the 1st quarter. Now they find the end zone again here in the 2nd. Sometimes you just have to...
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And they split the uprights last time for 3. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. The best way to do it.
And the running lane's non-existent in this 1st half as they'll stop him behind the line. They'll wind up losing 3. And now it's 3rd down. Here's Lawrence to throw. He's got his man. That's Hardman. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. A big play there as they get the conversion on 3rd and 13.
Go.
2 minutes remaining in this 1st half for football. And they'll throw on 1st down with Lawrence. Fighting a safety ball here. That's complete. And they're going to get this to about the 44-yard line.
And I like the idea here. Get the ball in his hands, even if it's in the passing game. 3 catches a week ago, and he does a nice job here to pick up yardage.
On 1st down, they'll go to the ground attack.
On a nice burst there as he'll take this inside the 30 to the 28-yard line. 121 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this first half.
And this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack. And guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
First and 10, it's Edwards-Helaire with it.
Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
One thing I have learned, receivers don't mind high throws so much to the sideline, but do that over the middle to them, and not only the DB's going to throw a little verbal trash their way, when they get back to the huddle, they're going to have a few words to say to the QB, aren't they?
Yeah, hung out to dry a little bit there on that. Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout as they get it right at the 30-second mark of this first half. They're going on fourth down. Lawrence trying to find his tight end Kelsey, and it's intercepted. But a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Well, these defensive coaches, they sure like what they've got in this rookie corner, and with good reason, as you saw there.
He only cost him a day two pick, and a lot of people thought he had first round ability. But when he was available on draft night, that was one where you didn't need the full time to make the selection. You call that pick in early, and it shows why he was so coveted with that interception there.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. The kill here is complete. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. Now the Jags will use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Back to throw here. And he works his way past the line of scrimmage and then slides to a halt. Now the offense will burn their third and final timeout. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. They'll send a receiver here in motion right. Second and 6. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. And the Chiefs will take over here as they get it up to the 43-yard line. Keep in mind, he had the 3-interception game last week, so we requested to talk with him this week. He was all smiles. He's still all smiles.
Yeah, we didn't jinx him at all, did we?
No.
Because ordinarily that happens, things fall off, but not in this case. I think a lot of it goes back to his technique, his ability to see the quarterback throw the ball while understanding where the receiver is running his route allows him to make a lot of plays on the football, and he's taking it away at a really high rate.
Quick throw, knocked away, and incomplete.
Well, he certainly didn't like what he saw at all from the coverage on his primary reads, and he didn't even have any luck trying to get back to his safety valve. Give defense a credit. Coverage was in lockdown mode everywhere.
And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter. Now Lawrence taking a deep shot here for Hardman. And that's the third interception for Lawrence. Picked up by Andre Sisco. And he will be brought down on what will be the final play of this first half. So we've reached halftime with the visiting Chiefs on top as we now go downstate to Orlando and check in with Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. And
we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Dawson. For the third quarter, the Jaguars with work to do. They trail here as we are back underway on EA Sports. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive.
Well, Charles, in that first half, we saw a fair amount of offense on both sides of the football, and now the team trailing here will start with it in the third quarter.
And we both know this coach pretty darn well, don't we? Because his game planning is always on point. And now that he's getting the ball to start the second half, how about all the offense that you already referenced in the first half? He'll put that all together and come out with something really strong, I believe, to get things going here in the third quarter.
Throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete.
And those two just haven't been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against him, but still, with his talent, you would expect him to have more completions to him in this game.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. Open man is Kirk, complete. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four. On third down, he'll drop to throw. Pulls it in. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk at 45. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. He'll look to throw. And he'll be brought down on the other side of midfield at the 43.
It was starting to become a game for him to forget with the interceptions, but that's a step in the right direction. Not only did he choose to run it instead, but he saw the field well and made a nice pickup to get a new set of downs.
Oh, he's going to let this go for the end zone. And that is incomplete.
There is something to a game plan with trying to keep a defense honest. With a guy with that type of speed, you do so. Send him deep, try to throw some air under it, and hope you connect downfield. On that play, they were unsuccessful.
So second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43. Here comes the blitz as they look to throw. And he lost the football, and it's picked up by the Chiefs.
So it looked like a good opening drive to start this third quarter, but ultimately it's going to be an unfruitful one as they give it away on the fumble.
Yeah, the way they were moving it, you figured they were in good position to take the lead, but they sure picked a bad time to be lackadaisical with the football. They wound up giving it away.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And their defense just helped him out by getting the football back on the opening drive here in the second half. And now can the offense follow through with points on their first possession?
And that's a big one for them because after the work the defense has done, they've got a chance here to open up this lead.
140 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon. Right back to him on first down. And some room to work. There he goes left side. And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown.
Well, he was already over 100 yards running the football prior to this play, but this run may be his best yet.
I've got to agree with you on that one. We're looking at a guy running with extreme confidence, running in harmony and sync with his blockers. All them kind of moving as one. And look at the end result. Big plays.
Extra point up and good by Garibay. And that pushes the lead up to 11. Garibay back out there now to send this one away. This is taken just shy of the 10. And he brings this out past the 20 to the 24. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Ashton Davis. And the Chiefs are going to take possession here
at their own 47-yard line.
Well, there's two sides to this coin. I mean, on one side, five interceptions now thrown for him. That's tough, but man, this defense, they have been ball-hawking and impressive. But Charles, let's flip it back over. If you're coaching a quarterback that's struggling this much at this stage of the game, do you maybe try to get him out?
I would think about it, and I think about it awfully hard, but also, you might want to look into his eyes, see what he has. He might be one of those players that you don't want to affect his confidence by actually pulling him out of the game. So you have to know your player. You have to know the situation.
Well, the first play of the drive lost four. Now they'll look to move it forward here on second and 14. Going back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And he'll be tackled at the 45 following a gain of just two.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
On the ready.
And the Jags, Charles, I think they're in the dime here.
Covering a lot of field.
And they'll run on the inside handoff. And this won't be enough. A good six. Give him nine on the carry, but it's not enough. And it'll be fourth down.
That was a good run, and it got to the second level. And what I mean by that is that's where the linebackers usually play, first level being the defensive front, last level being the secondary. But the strong safety position ended up making the tackle, and oftentimes we call them a hybrid, combination defensive back, combination linebacker. We saw the linebacker make the stop.
Try and throw for it with Lawrence. Completes it to Hardman. And he's going to be taken down at about the 33. That hold coming from the left side of the line.
Hands got caught in the cookie jar on that one, and the flag came out. Penalty against him.
Here's Ryan Stonehouse now, as he'll kick it away for the second time.
Yes, let's go right now.
He'll field this at the five. So a change of possession here on the punt. And it'll be Jaguar football as they take over deep in their own territory. They'll start on the ground with Gibson. And he'll fight forward maybe to the line of scrimmage, but that's all. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Maybe I'm wrong, but it looked like even if he had opted to keep that, I don't think there was going to be much to gain.
Seemed like it was perfectly defense, and know what they say. Those guys on the other side, they get paid too.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. 5 yards, now it's third and five.
In today's football, where receivers break tackles, make people miss, get upfield for the extra yardage, when you see a play like that where it's caught and he's dropped on the spot, that's a big-time play by the defense.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Looking to throw. Hard throw, incomplete.
Another throw there off the mark, and obviously he's battled all of the interceptions. Things just haven't been true to form for him. I don't know. What do you think's going on out there, CD?
That's a great question, and my suspicion is he's been coached really well to not show that he's having a problem. You know, they always tell you no matter what, you keep throwing the football with confidence. Well, we're not seeing a confident thrower right now. He's off balance, the passing game's off balance, and the defense is taking advantage.
They'll start out here with a jet sweep.
And some solid footwork there as he'll take this down to about the 38.
An 11-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Chiefs first down.
Boy, an effective play there, getting their wideouts involved in the run game.
And what they're always hoping on that type of a play, that they can get to the end of the line and have a chance to turn it upfield as he did there. That means they controlled the blocking and took care of the defensive end or the outside linebacker to give him that lane.
And I guess I need to clarify, I said getting their wideouts involved in the run game, but of course that was actually a pass as he popped it forward.
Boy, nowhere to go at all on that first down run as they will get to him behind the line of scrimmage.
You know, it's become cliche, but we have seen it and observed it. When runners have days like what we're seeing right now, they often take their offensive linemen out for steaks afterwards, don't they? They'll go buy them dinner. But after a play like that, he might reduce it, might go to the corner and just grab a hot dog or two, huh?
Hey, I mean, they've still been blocking for him well in this game. They don't get one mulligan up front.
Okay, so what we're saying then is we're going petit filet instead of porterhouse. How's that?
8 ounces is good.
All right, just checking.
Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first.
On third down, they're going to run for it here. Yeah, this is only going to be a gain of 2 and maybe 3. It's 4.
So many things going to making a good play on defense. In this situation, just not being blown out of the way was a big start, and then a nice tackle to finish things off.
On for the field goal try, Jonathan Garibay. This one from 46 yards out. Garibay's kick is good,
and that will extend their lead even further. So 3 field goals that he's hit. Now this last one helps him stretch out the lead.
He's been solid, hasn't he? And he lives up to the adage that every offensive coach has ever said to us. We want to end every possession with a kick, right? For them, it's either extra point, field goal, or at worst, a punt. In this case, it's been 3s.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive.
These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalpost, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least 2 first downs, because even if you have to punt then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they want to string together a nice drive and help themselves out.
They call his number again. It's his 6th catch and a first down.
And that's a nice catch there. Remember, he had the fumble earlier. No way he was giving up the ball in that situation. Secured it tight to his body and picks up the first down.
They go play action here on first down. He's going to look deep for more. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
I'm sure this isn't a novel thought, but maybe run some simpler routes instead of trying to get it all back in one shot. Defense certainly appears to be ready for him. Try and get it back little by little instead of in big chunks.
That's caught on the left side by Kirk. Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Rolling to his left. And I think the ball's out, but this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down. They'll look to throw here. And down he goes. They sack him back right around the 41-yard line. He couldn't get rid of it. He takes a sack for a loss of 6 to bring up second down. And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack. ETN up the middle. And this one also slow and developing as he's maybe getting back here to the line of scrimmage, but not much more than that. No gain on the play this time, and it'll be a third and long situation coming up.
18, right here.
They'll look to throw. He's going to look deep for more. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
Give it big credit for his coverage right there, because when he saw the route break deep, he stayed in position to prevent a completion while avoiding any risk of a flag.
Try it here. He's back to throw. Finds his tight end Ingram. And now this is going to be close. The defense says they stopped him, and they did. The Jags come up empty on fourth down, and the Chiefs defense comes up with a stop. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. Now there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball. Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, pulled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. And he'll be out of bounds, just shy of the 40. 23 yards the pick up there.
Partner, I like that they're staying aggressive on offense, because to me, this drive is what is known as a put-away drive. You score here, that might put this one to bed. I like the fact that they're playing with confidence and not playing with fear.
So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 41. Hands it off out of the gun. Down inside the 40.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge. He had to fight for every yard on that run. Shook himself free of a tackle and kept fighting, even with the rest of the defense closing in on him. That's the kind of effort you'll take every single time.
Edwards-Helaire, they'll try to run for it. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. This late in the game, Charles, I think you maybe seriously have to think about going for it.
Especially where they are in terms of field position, because this is almost like no man's land. Might hurt your punter because there might not be enough space, maybe too far for your field goal kicker. I'm like the old rule. Possession is 9/10 of the law. Possession is 9/10 of winning the game. Go for it. Get the first down. Close it out.
So that almost certainly the final piece to this puzzle, a 3-score lead. I don't think there's any coming back from there.
But you know, normally I'd get on you for giving up on the game right here, but I do think you're right in this case. This late in the game, 2 scores is tough enough. 3, I'm with you. That seems out of the question.
The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. Well, I think that the folks here had hoped that maybe this home atmosphere would carry their guys to a surprise victory, but it does not appear that that's going to be the case. There's too much to handle on the other side in this one. Give them 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. They'll drop to throw. And he's taken down, a Chiefs sack. That time, multiple defenders getting pressure, and it's a loss of 6. That's number 4, sack number 4. They had 4 last week, so he's been down on the ground a lot.
Partner, they say the eye in the sky does not lie, and that's indeed the case, because they watched the game tape from the previous week, incorporated into their own defensive scheme, and continued to get after this quarterback.
And now here is another interception. And the Chiefs are going to take possession of the football. Charles, whatever's going on between his ears right now, it's just not completely calculated correctly. 7 picks between last week and this week after that one.
And they always say the most important part of a player is those 6 inches between the ears. But right now, it's all those interceptions that are going on. So whoever his trusted confidant is on the sidelines, I don't know if it's the offense coordinator, the quarterback's coach, maybe the backup quarterback, that's who he needs to get with now and get himself calm.
They'll start by running the option to the right. And he is going to lose yardage here. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
But sometimes that option can get bogged down before the gears really even get into motion, and I think that's what we saw there.
And I think what he saw defensive end right in his face because he looked up and he was right there. Didn't even have a chance to get going.
On second down, they'll try and run the counter. And some room to run the ball. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. A big hitter there, a first down gain of 26 yards. And this time they're able to bottle him up as they'll stop him at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, second down.
No luck whatsoever there on the draw.
Yeah, they're supposed to use their aggressiveness against them. That was the hope. But maybe they had too big of a meal last night. A half step slow, and he ends up running right into the meat of the defense.
Let's go.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10.
Look at me. Go, go.
They'll run. It's Edwards-Helaire. And not even back to the line of scrimmage this time as they're on him quickly once more. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12.
When this offense gathers to watch the tape, they're going to like a lot of what they saw. They put up big numbers, but they might fast forward through that last play.
Oh, there won't be any fast forwarding, partner. I've sat in those sessions before. You end up spending more time on the bad plays than you do on the good ones. It's just the nature of coaches. But I know sitting in that room, when you've had a big game, the night that they've had, you don't want to hear that. You just want to focus on the good stuff.
Give him 3 yards there as that'll take us to fourth down.
On for the field goal try, Jonathan Garibay.
From the left hash, a 31-yard attempt.
Garibay's kick is good, and that will extend their lead even further. Well, ultimately, not really sure that they're going to need those 3 points, but they'll take the three, and they pad that lead.
Yeah, this one's already wrapped up, but you and I both know, if you're an offensive coordinator, you never let up on the gas unless the head coach tells you to do so, and maybe you've actually clicked him off in your headset so you can keep calling plays and trying to add to this lead.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive.
Facing a big fourth quarter deficit here, things not looking good. You know, this offense, though, they've been in the top half of the NFL so far this season, but in this one, where their defense has really struggled.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. The last play got just a yard. Here's second and 9 from the 26. And that throw behind his man, he missed him, incomplete.
This has obviously been a bad loss, but one of the few things they can still do is try and throw the ball all the way to the end zone and get some points on the board so they're not shut out over the final 2 quarters of this game.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on 3rd and 9. They'll set up a throw. That's going to be caught by Kirk. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds.
A 3-score game here late. You can probably rule out the comeback, but certainly some kind of a moral victory to be had if they can get a few more points to close things out. And to that end, a nice pass play there to push things downfield.
Yeah, and we know in this league, a loss is a loss, and no one wants anything to count as a moral victory or, boy, something that feels a little bit cheap. But if they trim that lead down to just 2 scores, that's still a benefit to this squad.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. His big game continues. 10 catches now, and another first down. Back to throw again. He's going to air one out. knocked away and incomplete.
Even with such a big lead late, the effort hasn't lapsed one bit. If the offense wants to score some points in this one, they're going to have to earn it. These guys are not giving up anything.
Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10. Again, he'll drop to throw. Finds his man yet again. That's Kirk. And he'll be brought down with a first down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs' 32-yard line. They'll look to throw again. Quick slant, caught by Moore. And he'll be brought down at about the 23-yard line. Second and one. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. Call it a loss of five, a big sack to bring up third down. This defense, they just continue to feast. Five sacks now as a unit. It's been quite an afternoon getting to the quarterback.
And we're seeing it come from a variety of places as well. Sometimes just the guys up front getting to him. Other times you have.
And he will get this into the end zone for a Jaguar touchdown. It's their quarterback, 28 yards. And the Jaguars have got it back to a two-score game here in the fourth. That touchdown, Charles, the first rushing TD of his rookie year.
I don't know that he's going to be Lamar Jackson or Russell Wilson or Josh Allen at this stage of his career, but he's got youth on his side. Those young legs, he put them to good use there, didn't he?
And here comes throw number one for the backup QB. That's caught. So unable to throw it in for two from the two. Let me ask you, as a former DB, what changes there around the goal line on a two-point conversion as far as how you're defending?
You just make sure you never back up and you never retreat. You establish yourself really on the line of scrimmage. Put your heels on the goal line at worst. And if they're going to throw the ball, make them throw it over your head because they're going to run out of space because of the back of the end zone. Never let a guy catch one in front of you.
Take a knee. So this one in the win column for Kansas City. Charles, for this losing side, their heads are hanging as they walk off the field today. And really, we know why. Those three turnovers by that offense, that's ultimately what doomed them.
And this is what coaches preach all the time to every team that we ever talk with. Taking care of the ball on offense, trying to take it away on defense, and let's face